I thought I saw a photo slash geo class. Hey, why don't you guys come with me?
How's it going? I didn't see you there. Today we're going to talk to you about hydrology, so let's get to it. Hydrology is the study of movement, distribution, and quality of water throughout Earth. The forms of hydrology we'll be discussing today are precipitation, oceans, rivers and lakes, evaporation, and transpiration. To talk to you today about waters and the properties of it, I'd like to head it on over to Blake Bassett.
Oh hey, precipitation is an atmospheric water phenomenon that includes any product of condensation of atmospheric water vapor that is pulled down by gravity and deposited on the Earth's surface.
Some examples are...
rain. Hail.
Ah, fuck!
And snow.
Hey, you in the green shirt.
Oh hey, to better explain the properties of water molecules, take both your hands. Nice. Now, put them together. While they're still touching each other, move them around. Ooh, very good. An even more impressive way to do this demonstration. Everyone at the table, please, put your hands in the middle of the table. Now, have them touch one another. Very, very good. Everyone, move your hands together. Now you got it. This is, in fact, a very good demonstration of a water molecule.
In the lab, we are trying to unravel the secrets of hydrology.
It is said that drinking too much water can actually cause hallucinations and delusions. Today in the lab, we are going to test out this theory.
Malkovich.
So right now, I'm going to show you the water cycle.
Finally finished. This is the water cycle.
This mini ecosystem represents a simplified version of the water cycle.
When the steam rises from the pot, this represents evaporation. The water dripping from the cover represents precipitation as it descends to the earth below. Would you like to know more?
Howdy. To talk about the other various forms of hydrology, let's take it to our operatives in the field.
Water cycle sounds like it's describing how water moves on, above, and through the earth, which it does, but most of the water is actually in storage in most of our oceans, as you can see out here.
It's a lot of is estimated that of the 332 million cubic miles of water supply, 321 million are stored in our oceans.
Hey, rivers and lakes are another form of hydrology. They are a direct result of precipitated water.
Hey again, rivers are formed when water accumulates. Gravity pulls all the water together into a great mass.
Evaporation is the process by which water changes from a liquid to a gas or vapor. Evaporation from the oceans is the primary mechanism supporting the surface-to-atmosphere portion of the water cycle. The large surface area of the ocean, which is over 70% of the Earth's surface, provides the opportunity for large-scale evaporation to occur. On a global scale, the amount of water evaporating is about the same amount of water delivered to the Earth as precipitation. Condensation, the opposite of evaporation, occurs when saturated air is cooled below the dew point. This is the temperature to which air must be cooled at a constant pressure for it to become fully saturated with water.
Transpiration is the loss of water from plants through a process similar to evaporation. Water evaporates through small pore-like structures called stoma.
Erosion is a process that takes sediment, soil, and rock particles from one place and deposits them elsewhere. Water is the most important erosional agent and most commonly erodes as running water in streams.
This is an example of water erosion in progress.
Another way that water erodes is when raindrops fall and move small particles of soil.
Well, that's hydrology in a nutshell. If you'd like to know more, go to this website. Thank you for joining us in the fascinating world of hydrology. Till next time.
And have we got news for you?
You better listen.
Get ready, all your lonely girls, and leave those umbrellas at home.
All right.
It's rising.
Rising.
I'm just getting low.
How low, girl?
According to all sources.
What sources now?
The street's the place to go.
We better
go.
Hurry up.
That's all, folks.